Hey, I'm here for round one, and we're on the play. I'm definitely gonna keep this hand. Currently, the hand doesn't really do anything, but any land I can play Thassa, and any creature that I draw will evolve Cloud from Raptor. So, most of the cards, or a high percentage of the cards in my deck, are a good draw. Mono red, which is a terrific matchup. Tidebinder Mage and Frostburn Weird are excellent, and obviously Master of Waves is nearly unbeatable. My opponent would get blown up by Rapid Hybridization, but unlikely that my opponent can afford to play around it. Because I'm going to be tapping out, I'm just going to bounce this Ash Zealot with Cyclonic Rift. And ideally, I'll draw a creature. Ooh, Night Vale Spectre is perfect. I'd much rather have a blocker than play Thassa. Okay. Ash Zealot and a Legion Loyalist. It's like no attacking for my opponent. Okay. This turn. So Master of Waves is not perfect against Legion Loyalist because the tokens cannot block. However, Master of Waves itself is a terrific blocker. I could potentially play Bident of Thassa and just try to draw a lot of cards. However, I don't think that that's a good play. I'm just going to play Master of Waves and not attack with anything. Because the only way that I can lose is getting overly aggressive and losing to Rubble Belt Makkas or something like that. Next turn, I can play Bident and just draw infinite cards off of the tokens. Even though holding back these two flyers is extremely conservative, I think I'm winning by enough that I can afford to play around almost everything. Okay, I'm just gonna block Ash Zealot with Master of Waves. I guess that my opponent could technically have Skullcrack, and that would be very bad for me. Maybe I should play around Skullcrack, even though these decks normally don't play Skullcrack. It would be kind of a blowout. On the other hand, blocking with one of my creatures and just losing to a pump spell doesn't really make much sense either. Okay, even though I think that it's likely that my opponent does not have Skullcrack, I'm gonna play around it and just block with the Cloud Finraptor. Okay, my opponent just said nothing. If you were unaware, Skullcrack does kill Master of Waves. It stops the damage from being prevented. Okay. About to draw infinite cards. I'll just attack with all of my creatures. I think I can race. And some of my creatures aren't going to be able to block anyway. At this point, my opponent only has three cards in hand, and I'm just going to end the game quickly rather than prolong it for no reason. All right, I'm victorious. Okay, against this version of Mono Red, Domestication is less good than it would be against a Boros Reckoner version. However, I still think that Domestication's better than Bident, and I'm going to trim one Thassa. Actually, I'll just trim two Thassa's for a Cyclonic Rift and a Dispel. And because I'm on the draw, I'm gonna cut a Nykthos for the second Dispel. And I'll play this for game two.